Hey y'all, iRig Sky here, and several months afterwards, do I regret making the switch from the Sony a7 III that I really loved to the a7 R3? Well, let me tell you my unfiltered opinion. So the a7 III, even though it uses the same batteries, I was able to experience greater battery life with it. With that said, the battery life for the a7 R3 is exceptional. It's not quite as good as the a7 III, but it grossly trumps the battery performance of the previous generation a7 R2. The a7 R3, when I'm doing portrait type work, photos, you know, photographing models, that sort of stuff, the a7 R3, it just knocks the socks off of the a7 III. The a7 III is good, but when you go from 24 megapixel in the a7 III to 42 megapixel in the a7 R3, there's a huge difference. Where the difference is really noticeable beyond photographing models, if you do product photography, especially more smaller type objects, you know, you can, with 42 megapixels, you can take a photo, and then within post-production, you can zoom in and not lose quality like you would with a lesser size 24 megapixel image. The disadvantage though, if you do, and you don't have to shoot at 42 megapixel with the a7 R3, but if you do, you know, keep in mind that those still photos are going to consume more disk space. So that's something to be aware of. Not this a huge deal for me. I use cloud storage. If I start to get low, I just upgrade the plan. Hopefully the scope creep of cloud storage doesn't continue to go up and up and up to where it's not financially feasible, but you know, we'll see what happens. But you know, overall, and I'll say the a7 III, the video autofocus, even with the same lenses, the video autofocus on the a7 III trumps the a7 R3. With that said, right now, I'm filming with the a7 R3 in autofocus, and you probably find the video autofocus, even with or without my sunglasses on, to be exceptional. And the bokeh, you probably don't see a lot of wonkiness in it. If I wanted to kick it to manual focus, obviously I could, and then there wouldn't be any focus breathing or anything like that. The thing that got me with the a7 III was that even in autofocus, how well it performed, because jumping from my old a7 R2 that I use primarily for video to the a7 III, the performance that I got from video with the a7 III was extremely better. I could actually depend upon the autofocus, whereas with the a7 R2 I couldn't in most every situation. But the a7 R3, even though the autofocus seems to be a little bit slower than the a7 III, it's drastically faster than the older a7 R2. So I'm happy I made the switch. And you know, it's kind of, to kind of summarize why I'm happy that I made the switch, I get the 42 megapixel stills when I'm doing stills photography. I still get great battery life, not quite as good as the a7 III, but I get those 42 megapixel stills. Also the LCD on the back, it's not a huge visual difference, but it is sharper, especially if you're doing product photography and that sort of stuff. If you look at the A7 III's LCD display on the back versus the A7 R3's display on the back, you'll probably find that the A7 R3's display on the back is greatly superior, and you can actually look at it and see the details, whereas on the A7 III you couldn't. I mean, that's a small advantage. And then, I mean, I'm not going to say the A7 R3 is exceptionally better than the A7 III, but I would say as an all-around tool, if you're doing, let's just cut to the chase. If you're doing video only, go with the A7 III. You're going to get better performance for video. But if you do really high-end stills, especially product photography, you're probably going to want that 42 megapixel, and the A7 R3 would be advantageous to go with it. Also, to really get nitpicky, and this is something that a lot of y'all may not see, but to really get nitpicky, if you pixel peep and you look at skin tones too, you're probably going to notice that skin tones coming out of the a7 R3 look better than the a7 III. And again, there is a price difference. Expand this video's description. You can find both the a7 III and the a7 R3 and the various lenses there. There is a significant price difference, but you know, even if they were the same price, I would still say, yeah, if you're doing video only, I would go with the a7 III just because you are getting a little bit better battery life and you're getting a little bit better autofocus. But if you're going to do both photos and videos, well, let me step back. So video only, I would go with a7 III. If you're going to do video and stills, but you're not a huge stills person, you know, maybe you're taking, you know, a few family photos, event photos, that sort of thing, then maybe the a7 III would be more than acceptable. you know, especially if you, if cloud storage and or physical disk storage is of concern, you probably want to have those smaller images that the a7iii will capture. So that would be another reason to go with the a7iii. But if you really are serious about photography, more so than videography, definitely go with the a7R3. And if you're serious about both photography and videography, definitely go with the a7R3. So, you know, it's just, you know, it's my opinion. You know, tell me what you think. Comment below. You know, I'm not a dictator. I'm just telling you what I've experienced, you know, from many years of experience using various cameras. And, you know, Sony has become my go-to camera. And a lot of that is, it was prompted by STK's Adventure Channel. And we were in Bermuda filming a marlin fishing trip. And he had one of the smaller cameras, the little RX100. And it was a great experience. It captured really rock solid images, and that turned me on to Sony. And you know, ever since then, I've been call me a Sony fanboy. That's fine. Now, I mean, I don't care. They're great. The lenses are great. The cameras are great, and they're great for both video and photo, and they're extremely portable. So anything you're looking for, any of the cameras, the microphone, my tutorials, subscribe to my channel, youtube.com/iRickSky, and ring the bell icon when you do to be notified whenever I post another video. And if you're looking for any of this equipment, expand this video's description and then click the links there and you can find where to order it online. And if there's something you don't see, just shoot me a message and I'll be more than happy to share product links with you. The best way to get me is facebook.com/iRickSky. Thanks for your viewership and y'all have a good day. Hey y'all, iRickSky here. Thanks again for your viewership. Be sure to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already and ring that bell icon to be notified whenever I post another video. If you're looking for iRickSky's Adventure Channel merch, like this t-shirt and a lot of other cool stuff, expand this video's description. You can find it all there. Y'all have a good day.